Hello all, welcome to today's video. Today we'll be discussing about one of the interesting topics in .NET, and this can be quite useful whenever you're trying to implement some features. So we might have encountered some situations in which it might not be possible to determine that object properties when we are writing the code or when we're designing the class. We will not be aware of what all properties it can contain, or it can happen that those class properties will change depending upon the context or depending upon which object we are trying to read. So it is not static properties. We can't define static properties in a class, or we might not be aware of what all properties that particular class can contain. The typical use case where it can be where it applies is when we are trying to read a particular file and we are trying to serialize or deserialize that particular file information into an object. Then in those cases, while designing our code, we will not be aware of what all properties, what all the object attributes are there. Therefore, it is difficult for us to define properties for those attributes which are present in the file. Therefore, in those scenarios, it is pretty much convenient to add properties during the runtime or during the program execution. We will try to the properties will be discovered and it will be dynamically added into that object that we are dealing with. There is a blog post which I have written for this. I will share the link in the comment section, and please do subscribe to this channel if you want to get notification about these kind of contents, technical contents, and do share with your friends if you like this particular video. Yeah, going on to our topic, proceeding with our topic, then we will just see, we have already discussed what is the use case of this particular dynamically adding the properties into that object. One of the use cases whenever we are dealing with dynamic content or dynamic data which we only get during the program execution, like the data is coming from a file and we don't know the template of that file, or we don't know the structure or schema of that file, it becomes very difficult to define properties for that particular data in a static class. So that is one such use case where we'll be using this particular concept. And here we are going to discuss about an object, a special object called Expando Object. Therefore, Expando Object is nothing but you can actually visualize that as a dictionary. Means that actually that Expando Object is defined by the framework for C# library, and it implements iDictionary interface. So you can visualize this as a dictionary where the key of the dictionary will be the property names and the value will be the property values. Therefore, these kind of Expando Objects help us to dynamically add the properties during the program execution. So I have defined one example with the working code, how we can use that Expando Object and how this particular properties can be accessed using that Expando Object, and later on printing the details in the console. Let's switch to the code now. And as you can see, this property info is nothing but a class which defines the what is the property name, or is the structure which defines the property name, corresponding property value, and what is the type of the property. This is nothing but a POCO class. And then comes the main program. In the main function, I have defined a list of properties. This is actually emulating a file read. You can just visualize this as I am reading a file. Instead of physically reading a file, I am defining the properties like this. I am defining a list of properties where the first property will be that author, and the value will be author name and the revision, description and cost. These are the four properties I'm defining. Instead of that, I can define these properties in a file and read it from the file. For the sake of convenience, I just defined the list of properties like this. And then defining an expando object, then we proceed to creating an expando object. As you can see, this expando object, you can see from where it is coming, where it is defined. If you go to the implementation of this expando object, we'll be able to see the definition. Yeah, it is coming from a system.dynamic namespace, system.dynamic library, and we'll be able to see the implementation of that particular expando object class. As I told before, expando object implements iDictionary or string object. Therefore, it is pretty easy to easy for us to deal with expando object, since it is a dictionary type which we are familiar with, already familiar with. Once we create an expando object, I am typecasting into an iDictionary or string object. Why I am typecasting into iDictionary or string object is to access the indexer operator, indexing operator, so that I can add the property name as a key and the property value as a value of that particular dictionary key value pair. So before adding the property directly, I am trying to convert the property value into its corresponding type by using the convert.change type, which is again from coming from the system namespace. And after adding all these properties which I have defined already, then try to recast or again typecast into an expando object. Book expando, I have defined it as a book expando, and I'm trying to access those properties which I've added already using the dot operator. Like normal properties, we will now be able to access those keys that we have added into a dictionary using the dot operator like a normal property. Like how we access a normal property, we'll be able to access those keys in the dictionary using the dot operator, like book expando dot author, which was originally added as a key to this dictionary, book dictionary. Since this is an expando object, we'll be able to access via the dot operator, dot author, dot revision, and these are all the keys to this dictionary, and description and the cost. The one important thing is how this particular thing is implemented. We'll be able to see by going to the definition of this particular expando object in Visual Studio 2022. It is pretty easy to us, easy for us to see the implementation detail of those library classes. It gets, you can actually see the how it is implemented. I will not be going into the detail of the implementation for the sake of simplicity. And I'm just writing the, printing that into a console, those expando objects value and the corresponding type, I'm printing into the console. Let's run this particular application and see what results we get. Yeah, as you can see, we are able to see what we have added into the dictionary or the expando object. All those values we are getting and the corresponding type also we are getting. I guess that covers expando object in brief. So this is an important special object to use in your application development if you are dealing with dynamic data. So thanks again for watching the video, and do share your thoughts in the comment section. Thank you.